You got your mama's sunshine, you got your daddy's rain. You're like a piece of heaven in a hurricane. And it's bubbling over like sweet champagne. You got your mama's sunshine, you got your daddy's rain. All day long, right or wrong, you question everything. Why the grass is green, can I stay up late, and why do bluebirds sing? Sometimes you cry your big blue eyes for no discernible reason. Your point of view, it comes and goes like the changing of the seasons. You got your mama's sunshine, you got your daddy's rain. You're like a piece of heaven in a hurricane. It's bubbling over like a sweet champagne. You got your mama's sunshine, you got your daddy's rain. You act just like your father, yeah, you laugh at your own jokes. You're pleased with your opinions, girl, you want the world to know. We don't need no Mona Lisa, don't need Dolly or Chagall. You're like a miniature Picasso with your markers on the wall.
What's up, guys? Welcome to another video. It's my first full day down here in Cornwall, Prah Sands to be precise. I spent most of the day just chilling on the beach, but it did get a little bit too hot in the end, so I decided to come back. I've just been doing a little bit of editing for last week's video and a little bit of the footage that you would have just seen. Just about to head out for dinner. I think I'm going to go to a place called Coach and Horses, which is a pub very close to here, and then I think the plan tomorrow is to head down to St Ives. Obviously I go down to St Ives every October, but it'd be nice to go down when the weather is nice. And then I think on Monday I'm going to be heading to the gym in St Ives called Revolution Fitness, where I have trained before. Chris, the owner, I messaged him a couple of days ago to see if he is open, obviously because of the weather and everything, but he said he is open, so it'll be interesting to see how I get on deadlifting 255 kilos for three in what is going to be the hottest weather in probably a decade. So we'll see how we get on, but yeah, hope you enjoyed the video. Let's go and get some food. It is an absolutely beautiful evening tonight. It's a little bit cooler as well, so I've gone for jeans. Apparently the Coach and Horses where I'm going to get food tonight, it's literally only a 5 minute walk down the road, so ideal. Lovely, thank you very much.
Alright, and do you know what you'd like to order?
To make it 30?
Yes, of course, yeah, that's very kind, thank you.
Thank you very much.
Perfect.
Amazing, right. Thank you very much.
You're welcome, thank you.
Thank you.
Well, that was some top tier grade A scran. Just walking back down towards the beach, hoping to see a little bit of a sunset, but I think that actually there's going to be a cliff in the way because the beach is over there, but the sun is over there, so I'm pretty sure there's going to be a big hill in the way. But either way, it'd be nice to just stretch the legs and get down to the beach, and the bar might even still be open, so I might be able to grab myself a cheeky beer. Today has been amazing. It's been so chilled. Just had a couple of drinks down there at the bar. Stayed open a lot later than I thought. I thought it was closing at 8:30, but it didn't close till 10. So had a nice couple of pints. Now I've got a little bit of a walk back to the cottage, all uphill as well. So it's gonna test a little bit of my cardio. But yeah, I'm absolutely shattered. So I'm probably gonna get home, edit this video, and then go to bed. And then tomorrow, we're off to St Ives. St. Ives, just heading to the beach, had some brunch from Scoff's Troughs, which is where I normally go. Unbelievable food there, just had a little cappuccino. Got myself a couple of books to read, so just heading down to the beach to chill out. Well, the beach was absolutely amazing, soaked up plenty of vitamin D. Now it's time to soak up some vitamin B. Beer.
Snap my fingers and require a wave from the clear blue sky to the lava. Screw your body and relieve your pain. In my darkest hour, she is standing there. Whispering words of wisdom. Let it be.
All right, I think it's now time for my second dose of vitamin B, burgers. Well, that burger was absolutely divine. For the rest of the evening, I'm just going to be chilling on the beach, letting that digest and watching the sun go down. Thank you.
Oh God, that was a test of my cardio. Just came from all the way down there on the beach. Probably can't even see that in the video, but yeah, lots of steps. Just going to the car, heading back to Prah Sands now, which is obviously where I'm staying, and then back here again tomorrow for a deadlift session.
Right then, I was going to leave the footage there for today and go straight to the deadlift session. However, I've just got back and had three scoops of the new matcha latte whey protein isolate because I haven't had much protein today, eating out most of the day. And then I've just been horrified to realise that, I was just having a look on the back because I realised it tastes so much like tea. Obviously it's tea flavour, but it actually tastes a lot like actual tea. And then I've discovered it has actually got 27 milligrams of caffeine per 100 millilitres. And I'm pretty sure I've just had about 500 millilitres of that just before going to bed. So I've just basically smashed the equivalent of a pre-workout before going to bed. See, I'm already sweating. Maybe I should deadlift tonight and find a 24-hour pure gym in Cornwall. No, let's not do that. I'll just put an episode of Friends on. That'll be enough to send me to sleep.
Oh. All right then, I am here at Revolution Fitness. It opens up in about 20 minutes, which gives me enough time to prepare my pre-workout. I'm not gonna point out the obvious. It is very hot today. And I did message Chris, who's the owner of the gym, asking if he has any aircon in the gym, and he said there isn't, and he did say it does get pretty hot, but he said he is also training squats, so I probably feel more sorry for him having to go heavy on squats than I do going heavy on deadlifts. If I was to choose one or the other, it'd probably be deadlifts, although they're probably equally just as bad. But yeah, I've got 255 kilos to do for a triple today. Obviously I did 250 last week at Horfield, and it's my final session before I go for a new personal best next week, so hopefully this session will build me with a bit of confidence, but I'm not holding out too much hope that I'm going to have that good of a session, just because obviously it is very hot today, and I have spent the first half of today on the beach chilling out. And to be honest, I really can't be asked to train today. But yeah, we'll go and get it done. Once I've done my pre-workout and once they actually open, I think it's 15 minutes now until they open. I'm also fueled up on pasties, sausage rolls and smoothies today because I went down to the Sandbar restaurant, which is where I went the first day I got here, and they were closed in terms of food, so I had to like just get snacky foods like a pasty. So I'm not exactly well prepared for today's session in terms of fuel as well, but we'll just have to go and get it done. I've also finally worked out what the Ninja Turtle Ghost pre-workout tastes like. It tastes like those rainbow lollies that you used to get. I don't know if you've ever had those, the round tree ones. Tastes identical to them. So in this weather, very refreshing. Oh, all right, let's go and sweat some more.
Yeah.
pretty happy with that session overall. Managed to get the 255 deadlift and then had a little bit of a holiday YOLO session on the bench. Worked up to 151, which would have been 1 kilo more than the last time I went heavy for a single, which would have been the Jubilee time. Around that time I went for 150, so I just wanted to chip that by a kilo, but obviously wasn't there today. Probably not the best day to do that, seeing as I've only eaten a pasty and a sausage roll today. It's now 6:30 and that's all I've eaten all day, and obviously the heat. Yeah, it just wasn't very advisable going for a single just because the body was feeling fucked, to be honest. But I think I can sort of justify or know that it probably is there on any other day, but just wanted to have a little bit of fun while I was in the gym. Just want to say a big thank you to Chris for obviously letting me train there. Obviously it's his gym, but it's just nice to see him and nice to hit some big numbers in the gym. Right, so the plan for the rest of the evening is to head back down into St. Ives and go and get some food, because obviously I haven't eaten much today. And then probably, if I've got time, go and cool off in the sea one last time, and then head back to Bristol, because this is my last day now before I'm meant to be heading back, because I've now got nowhere to stay. So obviously I can't stay here as much as I really want to. If I could, I would literally be staying down here all week, because it's just amazing. But yeah, I need to go down, get some food. I'm thinking like something like a steak. I just need something substantial to fill me up after that session. So yeah, let's go and see what we can get. All right, so before I head down to go and get some food, I wanted to stop off here at the very top of St. Ives, because just here is where my granddad rests. So a few years ago when he passed away, just during the sort of COVID times, we came up here to scatter his ashes. So this is the first time I've been up here on my own to come and sort of pay my respects and just come and say hello, Papa, because yeah, it's just nice to be able to do that by myself, I suppose, and just have a moment, even though I'm talking about it on camera to YouTube. But it's just something that I've wanted to do, so just gonna chill here for a little bit and say hello and then head down and go and get some food. But what a beautiful view that he has here as well, over the whole of St. Ives, and what a day for it. Absolutely beautiful day. So gonna chill here for a sec and then head down for some food. I must admit, when I first decided to come down to Cornwall, I was a little bit apprehensive, because I haven't really ever done anything sort of by myself and just gone on like a mini holiday, although it's only 3.5-4 hours away. I've never really done anything like this, so yeah, it's just been confirmation to myself that I should do things like this more often, because it's just been an unbelievable few days, to be honest, and I've really enjoyed my time down here. The weather has obviously helped, but just been able to sort of go and see things which I normally go and see with the family, but just to sort of be able to experience that by myself, it's been really, really good. So I'm gonna try and do it more often, I think. So it's taken me about an hour to actually get some food, so I'll settle for the good old-fashioned fish and chips and watching the sun go down again. It is like 8:30 now, so I don't actually think I'm gonna have time to get into the sea, but we'll see what's vegan.
Back in Bristol, got back late last night, got in about 12:30, I think. Obviously couldn't sleep until about 4 in the morning though, because of the heat. It was ridiculous. It's actually a lot cooler, I think, in Cornwall than it is in Bristol, just being a city and a bit more condensed. I think it's just hotter in cities at the moment. But no, I had an amazing time down in Cornwall. Really grateful to my uncle and auntie letting me stay in the cottage down there for a few days. It's just an amazing experience, just being able to sort of go down by myself and relax really, and just not have to worry about anything else. And it was nice to get a session in as well while I was down there. I didn't actually do the accessories while I was in the gym. I don't know if I mentioned that, so I think I am going to do those tonight. But I think I'm going to pretty much wrap up the video, because I did plan on just filming a little bit while I was down there, but I think I actually got quite a lot of footage, so I think if I just continue filming for the rest of the week, then it'll be a really long video, and I want to try and keep it that sort of 15 minute mark if I can. So I think I'm actually going to wrap up the video here, guys. To be honest, the training for the rest of the week isn't actually that interesting. I've got a heavy single on the SSB, which is only about 215 kilos. And then at the end of the week, it's just light squats to prepare me for the 265 on Monday, the deadlift. So I think I'll leave it here, but tune in next week where I'll be going for a new deadlift PB, the 265 for a triple. Feeling a little bit apprehensive about it because 255 didn't move incredible yesterday, but obviously there's a lot of factors that went into that session. So with a lot of recovery back here in Bristol leading up to Monday, I feel pretty confident that I might be able to still go for that. I'm going to go for it anyway. If I fail it, I fail it, but we'll see how we get on with that. But yeah, going to wrap up the video, guys. Hope you have enjoyed it. A bit of a different video this one, but hope you've enjoyed it anyway. Please leave it a like, subscribe if you're new, and I'll see you in the next one. Take care. Peace.